So reduce the following equations into the normal formula. Find the perpendicular distance from the origin and the angle between the perpendicular and the positive x-axis here. The meaning here this is the x-axis here and the y-axis. This is the line here. Okay. Then you just draw OA perpendicular to the line here. Then here this is the length of the perpendicular is P. Okay. Find the perpendicular distance from origin and this distance is the length of the perpendicular P here. And angle between perpendicular and the positive x axis. Means this is a perpendicular and this is a x axis. Here we want this angle here. So it is a omega. Therefore, equation of this line is x into cos omega plus y into sin of omega is equal to p. It is a normal formula. P is the length of the perpendicular and omega is the angle between normal with the x-axis. Therefore, write the first equation in the normal formula. Solution here, first one, x minus of root 3y plus 8 is equal to 0. And you remember that so P is always positive, length of the perpendicular always positive. Okay. Take this 8 right hand side here, it becomes a minus 8. X minus root 3y is equal to minus 8 here. I told you that P is always positive. Therefore, make this one as positive. In the positive angle, you cannot convert. In money, multiplying both sides by minus 1. You have to say in money, minus 1 is the multiply. So, minus x plus root 3y is equal to 8 here. Okay. Then dividing both sides by dividing both sides by root of okay. Here minus 1 square here. Take care minus 1 square plus then root 3 square. Root 3 it's a square here. It gives the root of minus 1 square is 1 here, then plus root 3 square is 3. Therefore, root of 4 here and the square root of 4 is 2. Dividing both sides by 2 here. So, it gives the x into minus of 1 divided by 2. Then plus y into root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2 is equal to 8 divided by 2, dividing both sides by 2. Then x into, if you compare this with this equation here, cos omega is minus 1 by 2 and sin omega is root 3 by 2. Cos is a negative, cos negative value. You know that cos negative in the second quadrant here. Okay, so this is the second quadrant here. Cos negative in the second quadrant and sin positive here. Therefore, suppose if it is a 1 upon 2 here, suppose if it is a positive 1 by 2, then the cos omega is 1 by 2, then omega must be 60 degree. Sin omega is root 3 by 2, so omega value is a 60 degree. But cos negative here, so you can write here cos of 180 minus 60 degree. Then plus y into sin of 180 minus of 60 degree. That is equal to 2 1s or 2 4s are cancels here. It is a 4 here. Okay. Here we are taking 180 minus 60 because cos negative in the second quadrant here. Sin positive here. Cos negative, sin positive in the second quadrant. So take 180 minus 60 degree here. That is x into cos of 120 degree here. Okay. Then plus y into sin of 120 degree that is equal to 4 here. So comparing this equation with x into cos omega plus y into sin omega is equal to ps. So omega is 120 degree. Therefore, omega is equal to 120 degree and p is equal to 4 s. So p is equal to 4. So p is what here? It is the length of perpendicular s. And omega is the angle between the normal with the x axis. Yeah. So this is the required result here. Okay. Second example here, y minus 2 is equal to 0. Take the minus 2 right hand side here. So y is equal to 2. And already this is a positive value here. And we can write this one as a 0x plus 1 into y is equal to 2 f. Therefore, x into cos of 90 degree plus y into sin of 90 degree, that is equal to 2 f. Cos 90 degree value 0, sin 90 degree value is 1 f. Therefore, comparing this equation with x into cos omega plus y into sin omega is equal to ps. So omega value is 90 degree and p is equal to 2 s. Okay, it is a required result here. Yes. In the third example here, x minus y is equal to 4 s. Okay, so 4 already right hand side, it is positive value. It is a positive value here. So you write this one as x into 1 f plus y into minus 1, that is equal to 4 s. Is equal to 4. Dividing both sides by so root of 1 square plus minus 1 square here, it gives a root 2 here. Therefore, x into 1 divided by root 2 here, then plus y into minus of 1 by root 2 is equal to 4 divided by root 2 here. Okay, 4 divided by root of 2. Okay. In this case, here this is positive and this is negative, means cos is positive. Compare it here, cos is positive and sin negative. You know that cos positive, sin negative is the fourth quadrant here. Therefore, complete one rotation is 360 here. Complete one rotation 360 by 360 minus it comes under which quadrant here? Fourth quadrant. ಇಲ್ಲೇನಿದೆ ಇವೆರಡು ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಕಾಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಇದೆ, ಅದ ಸೈನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಇದೆ. ಕಾಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಸೈನ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಯಾವ ಕ್ವಾಡ್ರಂಟ್? ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಕ್ವಾಡ್ರಂಟ್. ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಕ್ವಾಡ್ರಂಟ್ ಬರಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಒಂದು ರೌಂಡ್ ಹಾಕಿ ಮೈನಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಈ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಕ್ವಾಡ್ರಂಟ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಬರ್ತೀರ ನೀವು, ಹೌದಾ? ಸೊ ಅದೇ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಇಂಟು ಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ 360 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಮೈನಸ್ ಆಫ್ 45 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ, then plus y into sin of 360 degree minus of 45 degree is equal to, here rationalize here, multiplying numerator and denominator by root 2 here. So 4 by root 2 into root 2 divided by root 2 here, multiplying and dividing by root 2. Okay, cos positive, sin negative, so we are taking 360 minus 45. 360 minus 45 comes under fourth quadrant here. Therefore, here this is equal to x into cos of 360 minus of 45 degree here. So 5, 6 minus 5, 350 degree. 350 degree. Then plus y into sin of 315 degree is equal to, so 4 root 2 divided by 2 here. 4 root 2 divided by 2. Root 2 into root 2 becomes 2 here. Okay. Then here 2 1s are, 2 2s are cancels here. comparing this equation with comparing this equation with x into cos omega plus y into sin omega is equal to ps. Therefore, omega value is 315 degree. Therefore, omega is 315 degree and p is equal to 2 root 2 s. So, length of the perpendicular is 2 root 2. This length is 2 root 2 and this angle is 315 degree. Okay. So, this is also it. So, fourth example, root 3x plus y minus 8 equal to 0. Take a minus 8 right hand side here. So, root 3 into x plus y is equal to 8 here. And it is already positive here. Dividing both sides by, by root of root 3 square here. Plus 1 square, root of root 3 square is 3, plus 1 square is 1 here. So, square root of 4, it gives a pair. Therefore, x into root 3 by 2 here, plus y into 1 upon 2 is equal to 8 divided by 2, 2 1s are 2 4s are cancels here. Therefore, x into cos of 30 degree here. Cos 30 degree is root 3 by 2 plus y into sin of 30 degree is equal to 4. Both are positive. So cos 30 degree root 3 by 2, sin 30 degree is 1 by 2 is equal to 4 here. Comparing this equation with x into cos omega plus y into sin omega is equal to p here. Therefore, omega is equal to 30 degree and p value is 4 here. Length of the perpendicular is 4. Angle between normal with x axis is 30 degree.